Stanford University is a private university located in California. It was founded in 1885 by Jane and Leland Stanford and is one of the largest campuses in America. The university is credited for accomplishing the first successful heart-lung transplant, the debut of the computer mouse, and the development of digital music. Stanford has produced 19 Nobel laureates and many famous alumni with distinguished careers in the social sciences, business, art, humanities, politics, sports, technology, and media. Notably, Stanford's alumni body also includes 17 astronauts, 2 field medalists, 18 Turing Award recipients, as well as the 31st President of the United States, Herbert Hoover. Now, when you walk through Stanford's Oval, you get to the main quad, which leads you to an iconic building known as the Memorial Church. The church building gives you a breathtaking view with a captivating painting that will blow anyone's mind. It's easily the most impressive building on the Stanford campus. Everything in there is meticulously crafted with the super high ceilings, which give the church a much larger and more spacious feel. You'll also find artwork in the building made of tiny little tiles, which look like they would have taken an incredible level of painstaking work to fit together. It, of course, makes the church look stunning. The ambiance is really soothing, with the lighting and quietness that work together exceptionally to give you that sense of ease and calmness. As you walk along the quad, if you look down, you notice numbers on the floor from the early 90s to the late 2000s. Why is that, you wonder? Well, it's because there's a time capsule of the graduating class corresponding to each of these numbers buried underneath each of these numbers. Are they ever going to dig it up? Will we ever see what's actually buried in there? Well, it's anyone's guess, really. Anyway, moving on, the classrooms and dorms are located dead center at the Stanford campus. And talking about classrooms, engineering is the biggest major at Stanford. The engineering facility has an impressive lecture hall known as the NVIDIA Auditorium, which is like the nicest classroom in the whole of Stanford. The classroom is fitted with 4K cameras, which records all classes held in the hall. Actually, Stanford records most of their classes. This way you can access videos of past lectures online for any kind of research you're doing. Now, something you'll notice about Stanford is that it cares a lot about the computer science and engineering faculties. So a lot of funding goes into these faculties so they can keep researching and breaking new grounds. Don't be surprised when you walk in and find endless research centers at these faculties. Anyway, away from the engineering faculty, we move to one of the most beautiful parts of the campus, the Hoover Tower. The Hoover Tower is the tallest building on the Stanford campus, which isn't such a difficult feat to achieve when you consider that almost everything is super flat at Stanford. Anyway, when students aren't studying in the summer, there's this tradition they keep called fountain hopping. Since it's the summer and everywhere is hot, people just jump from one fountain to another like they're hopping in and out of swimming pools. It's really fun and refreshing and is part of what being in Stanford is all about. Now, the Stanford campus is really huge, and you can't just walk from one place to another. You have to bike everywhere, so everyone owns a bike. When it comes to student life, there isn't actually much to do over at Stanford. It's practically sitting in the middle of nowhere. So if you want to go out and have a nice time out with friends in town, that's like a 30-minute drive. Then you can get to San Francisco, Oakland, the Bay Area, and the likes. All right, back to the architecture and geography of Stanford. The Green Library, which is the main school library, is located right off the quad. It's really beautiful, and to get in, you need to register to get a guest pass first. Walking up the Marvell stairs inside the library, you'll see a display right ahead that changes all the time. Once it was a display of Leonardo's drawings and his notebook. To the right of the library is the West Stacks. The West Stacks refers to 7 floors of books, books, and nothing but books. There's almost no book you can think of that you won't find at the West Stacks. And then to the left of West Stacks is the reading room. It's a really nice area with bright windows and a chill atmosphere where you can get some quality studying done. Heading out of the library and back outside, there are parts of the Stanford campus that could give you a beachy vibe with the lineup of palm trees on each side of the road, standing in front of nice buildings that look like hotels. But don't get it twisted. Studying at Stanford feels nothing like being on holiday in Hawaii. The school is very focused on research and strong, rich academics. Sports is a big part of the Stanford experience, so there's the standard tennis court, the track and field race course, and a stadium where the big game is held. The big game is this annual game between Stanford and UC Berkeley, where both schools get together and compete in the game of football. It's a very important event for both schools, and Stanford won the most recent edition. From there, you could check out the trophies room. Now, fact, Stanford has the most trophies of all the schools in the United States. It's got trophies for swimming, basketball, football, tennis, you name it. Every big sport you can think of, Stanford has a trophy to show for it. At the pinnacle of the trophy room, with stairs leading up to it, is the championship cup for all sports in the D1 division, meaning that Stanford won the most number of championships across all the universities in the U.S. in the year 2017 to 2018. Away from the trophies room and back outside, one of the best lookout points at the university is the top of the Arts Building. If you stand there, you can see the Hoover Tower and all the Stanford campus. It's a very beautiful sight to behold. And then finally, there's the merch store, which is one of the biggest merch stores you'll ever see in a university. There you can help yourself to a wide selection of hoodies, hats, t-shirts, and nearly everything else you want. Okay, quick trivia. Did you know that Stanford's mascot is a tree with eyes and mouth? It's a little creepy, but also kinda cool in a weird way, right? Anyway, this brings us to the end of today's video. For more videos like this, subscribe to the channel and turn on the bell notification so you never miss an upload. Thank you very much for watching. See you guys in the next video.